Today we will do mean value theorems. There are two theorems. First is Rolle's theorem. Second is Lagrange's mean value theorem, which is generally called as mean value theorem, or we also call it MVT. Now, first of all, I'll tell you the geometrical interpretation of the two theorems. Rolle's theorem says that if there is a curve which is continuous in the interval AB, then there exists at least one point in the curve at which the tangent is parallel to x-axis. Now see, suppose this is the curve and this is continuous in the interval AB, then there exists at least one point. Let us suppose this is the point at which the tangent is parallel to x-axis. And what does the mean value theorem say? It says that if there is a curve which is continuous in the interval AB, then there exists at least a point C on the curve at which the tangent is parallel to the secant AB. So now we'll do the conditions and the statement of Rolle's theorem and Lagrange's theorem. Now see, Rolle's theorem says that if f is a function from AB to R, that means the domain of the function is AB and the range is R, then the condition is that if fx is continuous on interval AB. Now pay attention that this is a closed interval. What does closed interval mean? That A and B are also included in this interval. If the function fx is continuous on AB and differentiable on open interval AB, that means A and B will not be included. Why we do not include AB? Because see, if this is the curve, then there can be at the end points, we cannot have one tangent. We have multiple tangents at these points. So, we will not consider the tangents at these points. So, we will take open interval. And the third condition is that FA is equal to FB. Then there exists C belongs to AB such that F dash C is equal to 0. What does this mean? I had told you that if this is a curve and then there is a point at which the tangent is parallel to x-axis. So how do we represent a tangent parallel to x-axis? We say that f dash x is equal to 0 and it is parallel to the x-axis at the point C. So it should be f dash C is equal to 0. Now mean value theorem. The statement is let f is a function from the interval AB to R, again the same, that it is a function whose domain is AB and the range is R, then the condition is if the function fx is continuous on the closed interval AB and differentiable on the open interval AB, then there exists C belongs to AB such that f dash C is equal to fb minus fa upon b minus a. What does f dash C represent? In the geometrical interpretation, we had seen that if this is a curve, then this is the tangent. The tangent at any point is given by f dash c, and the slope of the curve at any point or the secant is given by fb minus fa. So if this is fb and this is fa, so this is point bfb and this is point afa. Then fb minus fa gives you upon b minus a gives the slope of the secant AB. So f dash c should be equal to fb minus fa upon b minus a. Now we will do exercise 5.8, question number 1. It says verify Rolle's theorem for the function fx is equal to x square plus 2x minus 8, where x belongs to the closed interval minus 4, 2. Now we know that fx is equal to x square plus 2x minus 8. So this is a polynomial function, and polynomial function is continuous and derivable over R. Therefore, fx is continuous on the closed interval minus 4, 2, and fx is also derivable on open interval minus 4, 2. So in this case, we need not prove that function, and we need not prove that it is continuous and derivable. We can directly write the statement. Now third condition was fa is equal to fb. See, fa, a for us is minus 4, so we will put f minus 4, that is x is equal to minus 4 in this given expression, x square plus 2x minus 8, so we get 0. Similarly, f2, how will we find? We will put x is equal to 2 in the given expression and we get x is equal to f2 is equal to 0. Therefore, f minus 4 is equal to f2. Thus, all the conditions of the Rolle's theorem are satisfied. Therefore, there exists at least one real C which belongs to the open interval minus 4 to such that f dash c is equal to 0. Now we know if fx is equal to x square plus 2x, then f dash x will be equal to 2x plus 2. So f dash c, that means we have to replace x with c, so we get 2c plus 2 is equal to 0, and when we solve this linear equation we get c is equal to minus 1. And now if we see minus 1 belongs to the open interval minus 4 and 2, and therefore Rolle's theorem is verified with c is equal to minus 1. Now next question, I'll take question number 4 because it is for mean value theorem. It says verify mean value theorem if fx is equal to x square minus 4x minus 3 in interval closed interval AB where A is 1 and B is equal to 4. Now again in this question the given expression is a polynomial. So we can apply the same properties that polynomial function is continuous and derivable on R. Therefore fx is continuous on one closed interval 1, 4 and fx is also derivable on the open interval 1, 4. There were only two conditions. So we will say that the conditions of LMB are satisfied. Hence there exists at least one real number C belongs to 1, 4 such that f dash C is equal to fb minus fa upon b minus a. What does f dash C represent? F dash C will represent, if this is a curve, then F dash C represents the tangent at the point C. And this is, so F dash C will be the slope of the tangent at the point C. And what does FB minus FA upon B minus A represent? It represents the slope of the secant AB because this point is BFB and this point is AFA. If I try to find out the slope of this line, that will be FB minus FA upon B minus A. So both the slopes have to be equal. So what is B for us in the question? It is 4. So we put f4 minus f1 upon 4 minus 1. So now how do we find out f4? F4 means the given expression fx is x square minus 4x minus 3. So f4 will be equal to 4 square minus 4 into 4 minus 3. That is 16 minus 16 minus 3 and that gives you minus 3. Similarly, when we solve f1, we will get minus 6. So when we solve the whole equation, we get 2c minus 4 is equal to 1, which gives us c is equal to 5 by 2. And it is visible that 5 by 2 belongs to the interval 1, 4. And therefore, mean value theorem is verified for fx in the interval 1, 4.